I said good day, sir!
Welcome everybody here to your last game of the night. It is the Defense Season 3. We as Asian going up against Arctic Gaming. It is our final game. As I said, we've managed to walk our way as dry. It's been a stroll in the park. There's been birds singing and then getting completely covered in snow. Because it's December in Europe, which means there's snow everywhere. But for accumulating people in Southeast Asia as well as America, parts of it, as well as definitely Australia. Shout out to your 32 degree temperatures. Which I will be experiencing as of Monday with 100% humidity in Malaysia. Yay! Say hi if you're in Malaysia. We're going to jump ourselves out of the game. Whoops. Okay, maybe we're not. We got a bug. We're not going to load. Ah, snap. Absolutely snap. We will be, in fact, kicking off this game once we have a bit of a remake. I want to tell you all, guys, check out if you haven't done so, the-defense.com. You can find the website with all the groups, all the details as far as this tournament does go over there. You can find it from either that website, which I just said, or going to joindota.com and going tournaments tab, clicking the little thing and off you go, as well as joindota.com, you'll find all the other competitions that are there. The changes up, the drafts, if you miss any of the drafts, that is now available. Statistics systems, which is actually now, from what I've been told, about 75 to 80% through. Which is kind of nice. It's kind of nice. That's actually almost 100% up to date, which means the statistics are a lot more accurate. And when it's 100%, it's pretty awesome. It's pretty awesome. We're back inside the game with all the players, so we should be good to start off in a couple of moments of time. Shout out as well to all those guys out there who were tuning in on this live stream, even though, like, I know that was definitely a big match. I know I'm checking out the VODs of LGD International versus LGD China. Even though I know the results, I saw the result in the ticker, and I'm like, no! Yeah, I know the result, but it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. I'm still going to watch the VODs. I hear there's a very, very awesome game in it. I also apologize to all those guys that have been tuning in tonight. I am still a little bit sickly. Well, it's not sounding like it until I start coughing, which I'm saying it now. I get a little bit of an inspiration because I'm feeling that little bit of a tickle in my throat. But you know what, guys? I have a secret to get through this game. It's the nectar of life. It's called water. Yeah. Yeah. Next level, huh? Next level. All right. So we just need a moment, and then the players are good to go, and I'm going to actually take a moment myself. I thought I stopped casting the French games. The frog is back in my throat. Yeah, love it. Absolutely love it. All right, so still waiting for our player to restart and get back into the game. As I said, this is the last game of the night, and we're moving ourselves into, I believe, actually Group C. I'm going to load up myself the defense website and find out for my own. For myself, luckily, you just got a little overview tab. You find out everything you need to know. For this game, though, we had stations. They are actually Group C. So Group C, we had Group D matchup earlier tonight. 3D Max and 25, they're the two boys sitting very comfortably at the very, very top of Group D. Two matches played out of that one. Group B, MTW, as well as Team Dignitas sitting at the top of that. And Group A, Pulse. People will know them. I had Wagamama, one of their players, joining me for the broadcast earlier this evening, as well as trolling the Twitter. If you haven't found that, just follow Toby1Dodo and you'll see everything there. Actually, I tweeted out a picture before of me in 2009 in China. That's kind of actually a bit of a freaky moment. It was a freaky moment meeting him and actually, like, talking to him for a while. Talking about drafts. His English is actually quite good, but you definitely, like, have a bit of a stagger back. I wanted to tweet out at the time when it happened. It was like, oh my lord, like, that just really happened. But I was in China, so Twitter didn't work on my phone for some wonderful reason because it's blocked. And also, you couldn't get net at the event. It was almost impossible. But yeah, he came up to me, shook my hand, said, Toby, I'm 2009. Like, yeah, obviously you're 2009. Like, you're 2009, man. He's like, I'm your fan. I'm like, what? It's no. Didn't happen. It didn't happen. It couldn't have happened. But it did happen. So there's a picture to prove it. With me and Caldor. All right. So, still waiting though. We're still waiting for, the load-in to happen from Atsy. Shout out to all those people out there too who are on YouTube and you know who you are, who make those comments. The game starts at 7. Long pause at start. and they put a time marking on the YouTube videos. I know who you are. I know exactly who you are. Quite quick, just reconnect back in again. So we're good to go again. But yeah, you know who you are. All right, so both teams ready to go. Let's get ourselves in the draft. Last game of the night. You knew we'd get there. You knew we would get there. Life was going to happen, guys. Life was going to happen. And life is Dota. And Dota is happening. Hence, life is happening. Let's get to launch ourselves in. Hi to all those people out there on Dota TV. We've had ourselves take number two at this one. So to all those people out there, the Bulletin Source Dota TV ticket, I greet you warmly. I've been talking to the live stream for a while now, but I get to talk to you guys for the first time. So if you are just like going, ooh, live tournament, it's on, I click this game. I'll see what the GO is, what's happening in the hood of like the defense. Hi to you boys. Hi. Warm, affectional greeting. Hopefully Dota TV is working perfectly for you. I've had no complaints tonight, which is great. Set it up so it should be working fine, and it's working fine. So, hey, wouldn't you believe the setup worked for once? Yeah. All right, that's fantastic. All right, let's jump ourselves inside the draft. So we'll have Arda Gaming. They'll be going up on the Dire side. It'll be We As Asian and the boys who traveled all the way down to China to compete down there. They said they went under the tag of Mouse Sports while they were there. But it was basically similar team. It was actually like Kurakai as well as Fader was in. We actually had a lot of stand-ins for We As Asians this evening. They're still being allowed to play, but their team ranking gets really dropped down. This is one of those things that got to remember really hurts that hurts the ranking of the team and can affect prize money if they're going to win it. Ashley had an absolute Legends manager contact us earlier tonight going, yeah, not happy with the team because they had a couple of stand-ins turn up and not their full roster. So the team ranking is actually having a team rating, sorry, not ranking, rating. It's having a fun effect on the sponsors. We As Asians, no sponsors for these guys. But Arctic Gaming, they've got theirs and they're there in their full five lineup. Batrider as well as Magnetor, their first two bans, which means we'll have Sven being picked up again in that same situation as we had in our last game, where the Darkseer pickup is available, and they take it just because it's Darkseer. But it does mean that Sven and Jakiro are options. We saw in the last time, though, that it was Sven as well as Templar Assassin were the two selections. As an almost counter would be, well, no, there goes Jakiro, and Sven will just be our classic one because she can't allow the combo. I said it during the last draft, and it's just as true then as it's just as true now as it is then, and that's the fact that if you have Darkseer back in, and then this Sven AoE hit, it's just too much. And they're going to give it to him. They take Luna instead. And this is a, like, not an essential pick. Like, Luna has been very, very well received by most teams of late. She has a lot of damage, got nice little nukage, and, like, oh, I'm not going to say Luna's a bad pickup. But when you've got that combination, which is possible, that comes out from this Sven and Darkseer, and if you're going to combine that up with an Enigma as well, so you get the Vacuum, you got the Sven Stormbolt, and then you've got the Enigma Black Hole, this chain off of abilities is just too much. And yeah, it's obvious as hell. Sven to be taken, and then Rubick too. So Rubick with the option of stealing off that Ice Path of Jakiro. Or if he gets lucky, Macro Pyre. Combine that one up. But he liked the Ice Path a little bit better, because that couples perfectly with what Sven's got. But Rubick as well as Sven, we know they're normally the start of what is a very, very nice, aggressive tri-lane. But it also means, too, and I know I hoped for her earlier tonight, and I might get a now from Kotchka if he decides to pick it up. And that's actually the Lina. I'm hoping for the Lina. Jakiro, SD, and Luna. This is just such babysitting-style heroes. But I'm actually hoping for the Lina selection, so we go with double nuke, and the Lina Light Striker Ray can be set up pretty easily with the Rubick Telekinesis. But it's this triple nuke that comes out through the Feybolt of Rubick, and then with the Dragon Slave, and then with the Light Striker Ray. And then Sven's also got his semi-nuke, but it's damage with the stun, an AoE stun. And that's the Stormbolt that comes out from him. And that's a lot of damage, and this can all be done with like the focus as well of Darkseer. Because Darkseer pulls everyone in, and then you got two AoE stuns, plus the Laguna Blade as well, and that's going to be enough to eat through the life of Luna. Bring her down nice and quick, and that's really, really great in the early stages of the game, before Luna's capable of getting that BKB up and running. But in order to do that, though, It means they have to sacrifice, and that means running no jungler. So they'd have to look to run an aggressive trade lane and shut Luna down very early on. Leave Darkseer to solo up the bottom lane, which means they'll have to start removing off those bottom lane heroes, and they're just removing Queen of Pain as well as Klinx to start with. So feeling that Arctic are running an aggressive trade lane with the Luna, Jakiro and Shadow Demon. TA will be banned because we are missing the mid solo for We As Asian. Yeah, still has not been selected just yet. But then again, Bounty Hunter is also still... I don't know, Bounty Hunter got taken out. Second ban taken out. Windrunner is the available hero, but Windrunner's counted on both sides. Both Rubick and Jakiro are great at controlling Windrunner on the offlane. Obviously, you got Ice Path, which means Windrunner can't walk through it. And you got Rubick, who's able to get that telekinesis pick up and hold Windrunner in position. And that's more than enough time to catch her out. And if he's able to time it properly after the Windrun's popped off, you're able to get away. I'm glad everyone in the chat is agreeing that the three heroes will be in aggressive try lane. It's quite possible. It is probable as well. Going up against Fen, get a couple of catches off on him. Jakiro able to do what he needs to do. Shadow Demons are set up. You can run him a little bit differently though, and that's as a support, and that's babysitting. So Shadow Demon wants to be the harassment on the offlane. There's that Enigma ban, waiting for that. And Invoker being banned out by Kochka. But you can run Jakiro supporting one melee here in the middle lane. Try and force Sven to actually go mid. And then Rubick can team up with him. And then we see there's like Jakiro plus, like, I don't know, Brewmaster up against Sven and Rubick. And then Luna Shadow Demon on the top lane up against Darkseer. And Luna will be happy up there. You just get like the same build as we saw earlier from Avorst. Just boots with a couple of rings and consumables and get those... the Tranquil Boots up and running as well as your Ring of Aquila. So you get your regeneration, you get everything you really want. Now the last two bans to come out from last two pickups from We As Asian. Who is going to be their mid solo? Queen of Pain taken out, Invoker taken out. So they're actually almost banding up against themselves when it comes to that mid lane. They would have expected Enigma to be banned out, and Templar Assassin, they already knew about that one. So who do they want to run the mid? Who is that big hero? Is it actually the dual lanes? Is it the dual lanes we're looking at? Well done to all you boys out there that are yeah, smooth. Shout out to the IRC chat. Shout out to the IRC chat. If you didn't know that Arctic Gaming is actually from Peru. So we've got, we're talking about it before we actually started the game up, and I should probably, reiterate the fact they're from Peru. But Arctic Gaming are from Peru, and then you got the Germans, which is We As Asian. Bane Elemental. So Nightmare, again, another nukage that's there, and another setup hit. It does, like, beg the question, are they now looking at an aggressive tri lane? Run the Bane, Rubick, and Sven up against at a defensive tri lane of Arctic. It can go either way. Get the Nightmare up and Shadow Demon. There's no disruption to follow through. Ruby gets a pickup. Sven gets a stun. They kill off the Jakiro. Then move over to the Shadow Demon. Windrunner will still be picked up now. So there's the offlaner we're talking about before. But Windrunner, a hero that hates going up against both Rubick as well as Bane. Pop the Windrun. You've got two abilities which are capable of holding you out. And that's Nightmare as well as Rubick's telekinesis. So Windrunner will have a very, very hard time if it is the tri-lane defensively for We As Asian. But the fact they don't run a jungler does lead down the lines that either they want to try and contest what would be an aggressive tri-lane from Arctic Gaming. Or they just want to go like, well, just find the tri-lane wherever it is. Make it a 3v3 no matter where it is. Go for a wander, put down the wards, lock off what you can very early on, and then just die from a cough. Not the healthiest thing in the world, really. How do you think Rubick lost his mouth? He coughed it straight off. Nightstalker being the final one. We're actually looking at the dual lanes. We're actually looking at dual lanes from We As Asian. So it was actually a little bit of what I was expecting of the dual lanes of We As Asian. So it's Venom, Nightstalker. Nightstalker can go solo mid. And depending on the pickup from Arctic now, it's in their hands that if we see dual lanes or tri lanes, and Naga Siren will be the final selection. So it's almost like they want to run. What do they want to run? Is it meant to be Naga and Jakira mid, Luna SD safe lane top, and then Windrunner on the bottom? Which will put Nightstalker as well as Bane or Rubick in the middle lane, and then Sven plus Bane or Rubick on the bottom lane. Or you could switch that around either, too. Like, maybe you want to protect the farm of Nightstalker, so when we hit that first nighttime cycle, he's got some good levels up, got some easy farm. But let's check it out. The best answer is always the way the teams walk out, but we're going to check out our boys from Peru to start with. So I'll start with the Naga Siren. She's already built for a quick bottle, so she will be going in towards that middle lane, be played by Smash. Iwo, or Iwo, 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 Iwo. I want to call you Iwo. Iwo, Iwo. I like Iwo. Your name is now Iwo. He'll be playing the Lunar on the bottom lane. Built for off lane to start with as well. It's a very early like gauntlet, which is interesting kind of style. But yeah, gauntlet there. So it does look to be an aggressive tri lane from them. Mystico. He'll be the Shadow Demon. I love these guys' names. Masoku. Yeah, Shakiro. And then Nova. Best name of all. He'll be taking up the Windrunner role. They're already looking for First Blood and Darkseer. They're looking for the rotation up, and the time is going to be there. Disruption to start with. Luna coming in. The Luna Blessing's already there, so everyone's got the bonus damage. How fast can they bring him down? Shackle holding the Darkseer for a moment. Now the Ice Bath. It will be enough to bring down Cry. Yeah, he's going to take a fall, and now moving on to Not a Hack. Damn, there's a lot of damage very early on. Riptide did his job. And now maybe a little bit more. There's a line for a Shackle. Salva's cancelled off. Nightmare holding the Lunar in position. The Ice Path is going to hold the Bane here. And it's going to be another kill. Another Shackle flying out. Everyone wants to die from the boys from Peru. And Shadow Demon has to disrupt. Has to disrupt the Lunar to ensure she lives. Already with the Tango munching. Is there a Salva to hand over to her? No, there is not. I'll have to just share out the Tangos. But two kills already going the way here of the entire side. Nevada Gaming, Windrunner gets one, Shakira gets the other. And then supports for all apart from Luna. She was the only one that wasn't a team player, she only did damage to one of those heroes. But the lanes start to settle up now, so it'll be Naga Siren going up against the Nightstalker in the middle lane. Nightstalker who started off with a bottle rush, and that's not working for him. What's coming out in the courier already? Bringing out the magic stick down towards the bottom lane. So that's the start for Shadow Demon. Meant to be a bottle rush for Naga Siren. Well, two assists should have actually helped her a little bit more than she did, but because she had to use up all of the consumables, it's not really helping her out too much, but holding Nightstalker off the lane should actually be, at the end of the day, a bottle at the same time. But tri-lane versus tri-lane, we're going to get it on the bottom lane. So defensive lane for WeHazation, they're already looking to pull, and, well, Camp, again, I love this ward. Love this ward. I call this the Bamboo ward, because Bamboo was one of the first guys I saw do it. Why is someone saying Arctic is from Brazil? Arctic is from Peru, man. Arctic is Peru. I'm actually just double checking this too, so I'm not actually being a twit and saying, yeah it's obviously this. Yeah. This bottom lane. It's gonna be so hard for Not a Hack to get any kind of last hits. What are we already looking at? Sven, 3-2. Actually not too shabby. But then Luna, 2-2. Yeah. It's actually quite balanced at the end of the day. And then Nightstalker, 7-3 up against a 2-0 up on the Naga Siren, because we saw a great lane up before with the Tide Hunter going up against Nightstalker. That still meant the Nightstalker got absolutely nothing in the early game. And then he rotated, went around getting kills, and then all of a sudden he got everything back again. But Naga Siren has negative armor, not negative damage, so Nightstalker still getting his last hit. It's going to work for him. And because there's these tri-lanes on bottom lane, it just, there's no support for the melees. It's just man on man. Or in this case, rather weird woman on very unusual man who kind of looks like one of those horrible things from like Blade. Radiant's top tower, but he is a Night Stalker. And then now towards our bottom lane again. Jakira gets a return. Say hello to Not a Hack. We're still trying to find that farm. And this one, Luna's able to get a lot more control because Rubick is doing no harassment damage whatsoever. This Jakira and SD are doing everything they need to do for him. And the only problem they have is if Bane catches one of them out with a Nightmare. So we're talking about that problem that would happen. What if Bane gets, what if Shadow Demon gets Nightmare? Ice Path doesn't hit. They lose two of their control abilities straight away. And Luna has to stand her ground. That's not really Luna's meant for. Ice Path gonna set up. Ven's done. But it only holds the Shadow Demon. He's not the one that needed to stop. He just stopped the Luna instead. Warcry to pop off, and then all of a sudden, armor. Plus four armor from that one level of Warcry. And you just don't find the damage for that. But it's control. Forces Ven to pop off abilities. 25 mana doesn't really care too much, and that's why now Clarity's popping off on him. But while this Clarity is going, he's got to hold back off the lane. The problem with Ven, it was actually one of his big original problems, and still is his problem right now. You pop off one stun, and you got nothing. Like, what are you really running here with Ven? He's got a Storm Hammer, as well as one Warcry, and he's out. And then Lucent Beam cancels off. We've got Disruption, we've got Ice Path. There's no Storm Hammer, he's short by one mana point. Telekinesis got thrown in, now the stun to Luna. Nightmare, nope, no mana for. He's already used up his Brain Sap, Dual Breath. This will be another kill on the bottom lane. The Lucent Beam came in at the same time, but Shadow Demon was the one with the last right click. And Bane on the sideline, so Sven can't farm up, and Bane's gonna walk out. He'll come up with consumables for the rest of his team, but not a hack. Look at his life, he's on 240 life points. This salvo's gonna come from Rubick. He's gotta give that to Not a Hax right now. But then again, Not a Hax kinda wants this farm. So he's gotta make that decision. What is better to give away? Well, a Naga with a bit of a haste rune, just being a pain in the butt to crit. And then a 4-minute rune's gonna spawn up on top, and Naga with the haste wants to run up. Ensnare, ensnare, ensnare. Nope, doesn't even need it. Picks up the regen. And then uses the haste rune again. She can dive this too, she knows she can. Ensnare, Riptide, right click. In fact, gonna pull the mirror images. Easy dive, mirror images towards the front line. Haste rune hasn't worn off just yet, and this will be the death of crit. Void, let's try and slow him down a little bit, but it's not really helping out. Now the right click, there you go. Solo kill in the middle, using the haste rune, pops the regen, gets everything back that she needed. And that's a solo kill in the middle lane, which means level 6 now up for Naga Siren. And we as Asian getting schooled on the lanes. Completely schooled. Of course, the rune control is just beautiful. But Nova even on the top lane, 23 for 13. This Windrunner's having a great old time. And Darkseer at 14 for 1 up against the Windrunner at 24 for 14. This Windrunner is worthy of Line of Heaven. And now treads up on Naga. Nice stalker with that death. It hurts him a little bit more. So it means coming into this first nighttime cycle. He doesn't have all these abilities that he really wants. When we're talking high levels up in Hunter of the Night, we're talking at least one point up in Crippling Fear. So when he does run, he doesn't have heroes like Shadow Demon causing him issues, or Windrunner landing off shackles, or just Wind running away. So he can't right-click it. Cry's sitting in behind the tower right now. Remember, 3 points up in power shots, a lot of damage. And normally when a Darkseer does this, he'll just sit in this general region, and getting a power shot through that line, normally pretty easy. Especially if he's prepping himself up by popping that Sol Ring to get the mana. Looks like a setup on the bottom lane. They're just moving around the tree line, searching out. But with this little tree line cutoff path here, it does allow Quatschka to move a little bit closer and hide in the trees a little bit more. 6 minute rune run again. Crit's gonna move a lot faster, but then again, ensnare. Doesn't need it. It's bottom lane. So Illusion Room at the same time, Nightmare's out, and Luna, they've got to get down here now. Luna's not going to be able to escape from this, actually, maybe with 4-1 charges pick up, needs those 1 charges to pop off right now. Nope, not enough, the Brain Sap takes him out. Same time, Darkseer dies on the top lane. Disruption, Ice Path, how much damage does the support hero's got? Not enough, not when the Warcry pops off from Not a Hax, but he's got no mana left. Warcry was his last-ditch effort to get his teammate out to safety. And Nova was the one who soloed up that top. And I wouldn't have been surprised if it was, Darkseer again, just doing exactly what I said, using the Soul Ring, Iron Shelling up, try and take up the creep wave, not having enough regeneration to live through it. Let's see what he's got. Stout Shield and Soul Ring, that's it. One power shot and a wind run, you can chase anything down, Lucent Beam, more than enough damage. So this tri-lane again from Arctic works very, very nicely. And both crit now on the bottom lane with Not a Hax, trying to repair the balance, which is just not here on the bot lane. And then Shadow Demon Illusion. Illusion Rune's gonna scan him off. Crit shows him. Oh, Not a Hax. Oh, man. He is gonna be pissed. Pissed is the best word. Threw out the stun, thought it was real. And we're already talking about his problem with low mana. If he's Max Manor, he can get two stones off, but can't even actually pop a Warcry. And now the bottle arrives. And he's popping it not for health, but for mana. That's not what he wants to have happen. Doesn't want to be on low life, but bottle and courier back. He's still only got one stun now, sitting at 274. If he wants to put the Warcry, as we said, you know what's going to happen then. He's got no one charges. That might be enough to give him an extra Warcry hit. Looking for that 8-minute rune. Ensnare? No. Regen rune. And bottle. Couldn't stop it. Now the ensnare is there and lines up for a shackle. Wonderful play by Nova. Absolutely perfect play by Nova. The setup was there. He knew he couldn't find another line for a tree, so he had two options. One was to go from this line and then do the attack out that way, or move to this line and do the attack that way. Either way, it was a Darkseer caught and killed. I hope you guys can see that in the river. And then back up towards the top lane with more farm. Phase Boots plus Ring of Basilius. And what we got up in the courier, Buckler, full mech recipe up as well. This is that bottom lane just working for him. Well, apart from this, this is not working for them. Luna getting sniped off. Four heroes, though. Committed to get this kill on the Luna. That's great, but Windrunner's still getting free farm. Same with the middle lane. Nightmare up into Kiro. Void. Yeah. Still on cooldown for three more seconds. Ben Stun goes on Nightstar on the SD. He disrupts up. Three on the Ice Path. Absolutely perfect. They will still get the kill out in the Shadow Demon, but Windrunner TP's in. Looks for the Shackle. No mana is there. Void it up. And there's nothing in the kit. Ice Path hits, and Phase Boost easily able to run in nice and close, and it won't be enough damage to kill him off just yet. And with that Void coming in, nice nukage as well as the Void, obviously, I say, like, Brain Snap. Oh. Brain at the end of the night. Brain Snap plus the Void from Nightstalker completely destroyed the life points there of the Windrunner. And that's a big kill as well. That's a level 9, almost 10 levels up, killing off that Windrunner. And then Cry's able to get some space on the top lane too. Middle tower has fallen. At the same time though, it's still going to be a tier 1 for a tier 1 trade. Well, maybe not. Cry doesn't actually have enough damage to finish this. He does have 4 points up in Iron Shell, so he can get rid of the creep wave pretty fast. But you know when that happens, Windrunner's going to TP up towards that top lane and protect it. And that mech is hers. That's where the cash is going in for the Windrunner. So they're giving her early farm, giving her early levels, and then she just becomes this support Windrunner. And now Naga rotates up towards the top lane too. With her song of the siren, she can set up perfectly for Cry and give that basically position for Nova. Riptide, Shackle, can ensnare and Shackle, Latch's death. Quick channel power shot, ensures the kill. Probably excess mana to be used, didn't really need to do that. Right click was more than enough. I didn't want to take a risk. And Naga and Windrunner are going to team up to push out the top lane. Mana style on the way for Naga Siren, already with that Yasha. It's like Shadow Demons on the walkout through the bottom lane. I don't know if you're searching for that 10-minute rune. It was already taken, which is the rune that was on top of the Naga Siren with that haste rune. What helped to set up for that kill. Again, another rune. Just this control for Peru. The entire country is now playing up against the We As Asian. Peru versus Germany. And Snare. No line for a Shackle, though. And Windrunner's not moving into it. All they wanted was the tower. And then Naga Siren ultimate. TP's out, ensures the tower, ensures no casualties on the Windrunner. And they're all out to safety. In fact, the TP's coming down towards the bottom lane. That's where Nova turned to. And with Phase Boost, he better get himself there fast. Shadow Demon Disruption. Double TP's coming in. Not a hax, locked down. Shackle will fly. Does not get the lash and the power shot, however, will get the kill. Rubik's already dead and crit with an Iron Shield on. Wants to get in nice and close. Ice Path. Oh, wow. He's actually caught in there. Ice Path will fly. Spends out on the Shadow Demon. Dual Breath, something slows him down. And then Eclipse comes on down too. Not a hax can take a fall. The crit, that damage coming out with the 4 points up in the Iron Shell, but then lose a beam. And Cries on the run. There's no Shackle. Actually, there is a Shackle, but he's just not in range. Power shot, lose a beam! Beautiful! Svenstun will come in. Damage to kill off Nova is not there. The phase boost will be too fast. Nonahax will just have to keep on running for that one. No one charges. We're 10 mana points away from another lose and beam. And if Luna overstays a welcome. Oh, was that actually a TP coming down towards the bottom lane? Could have been Bay making his way in. Naga's gonna make her way in. Snare is there. Right click. Ice Path. Perfect. No, not even doing it. They want the damage. They want the Jewel Breath instead. Ice Bath is still available if they want to do it, and that cancels the TP. Says the death will come, and that's 135 gold thrown out the window on the bottom lane. Pretty sure that's actually the second TP. I might be tripping a little bit, but that's the second TP that was lost on the bottom lane. Gonna check the stream. Good thing about it being on a 2-minute delay. Able to do such a thing. Radiant's bottom tower has fallen. And now 2.1k gold up on Luna. So full drums. I guess RS doesn't have the ult in all, but we are only 13 minutes in. But it's just great control coming out here from Arctic Gaming. Yeah, look at that advantage. Almost 10,000 worth of gold, 7,500 worth of experience. It's a lot to play around with. And now I get to watch. Oh, there we go. There's our second. And because of the second, I don't have to worry about missing a kill. I can check for that secondary TP. Using the sound effects, the first TP was definitely there, but checking if it's a secondary one, that's another thing. Ah, that was such a beautiful, beautiful power shot. Wonderful power shot and the loose and beam combo. Just a nice little positional play, and then forcing him back. And that would have been the time right then that the TP should have happened. Oh, I moved my camera away. Oh, noob, I must be doing it from sound. Yeah, definitely was doing it from sound, so. Pretty sure that's two TPs. I'll check it later. Yeah, just a quick pause out. So, Paul's actually coming from Arctic. They lost their Windrunner. That's obviously a big problem. You're going to build up a 4-staff too. Even with the changes, people will never give up on the 4-staff. Especially when you need a hero like Windrunner, who's just such a positional style hero. Like, I've already been talking tonight about the position of the Windrunner. And just setting up nicely with the ensnare, like, the line was right for it. You get that line, off you go. Get those proper shackles, and if you're able to find two heroes together, the entire team fight changes. I'm looking for Courier. Phil Yasha now. And that's going to be there for Luna. So in fact, not finishing off the drums to start with. Going straight to the damage dealing item of the Yasha. And then Shadow Demon. He's going pretty raw. But with Magic Wand, still with Smoke. Maybe an opportunity for some form of aggression somewhere on the map. And then giving some levels to Jakiro now as well. Space in the middle lane for him. The Naga Siren with level 11. Already with a big ult, probably coming into the side shop to pick up the TP. There's Nova coming back into the game. And there's our go. Such good manners. Apologize for the delay. And off we run. That's crit. Not the best time for him. We're back into a daytime cycle, so second daytime cycle, because we start in daytime. And they're looking for the Luna. Luna trying to farm up a little bit more of a stack here. It's not a bad stack, it's a big stack too. And then Quatchfoot gets to pick up, pull back, but there's no real support coming in time. Heard a war cry pop off, and I think Savan wanted to get in close, but it's so difficult. Go remember, it's not only just that damage that comes out from the Yasha, plus the movement speed too, plus 10% movement speed. That's absolutely fantastic for a Luna. In fact, trying to catch it down just then, like you look at the movement speed of Luna, 445 is what we're checking. 445 movement speed. Nice target during daytime, 350. I don't think anyone, in fact, has the legs to chase. 340 on Kochka. He's the only one, and actually Bane. 365, but no. Still short about 100. And even with the war cry, bonus speed of 12%. It's going to help out, but not be enough. Luna is still going to be able to outrun every single hero on the Weas Asian side, unless they get surged. Only other scenario that would save them. Or it's nighttime. And then Nightstalker can outrun everybody. What was that? Bonus movement speed? 35%. I trump you. I trump you, your 10%. Has been denied. Oh, there's Windrunner finally taking care of that top tower. It's a little bit of gold, but it's also a lot of gold being denied. 500 gold being the difference between denial as well as normal. Wall is being planted down. Want to keep close tabs. Never to break the smoke for that either. I'm smoking to plant the ward and then smoke up as well. We as Asia now looking to go. Warcry will pop. Four heroes are here and the smoke being revealed. Got to get a quick ice bath. Nightmare, however, will not allow for it. Then the stun. Nightmare broken. Void. Nice disruption. We'll buy a little bit of time. Luna. Eclipse time. It's eclipse time. Bane just melts in the mix. Darkseer throws down the wall, but no one wants to be anywhere near it. And that's also going to be Shadow Demon dropping on down. Windrunner's here looking for the Shackle line. There is one there holding crit in line. And Sven with a stun. The God Strength already being done, but Luna, look at that speed. So fast away, pops off the drum charge. And Nova also moving so damn fast. Pick up, throw down. Maybe enough damage to bring down the Luna, but then again the mech charge. And then Shackle holds crit and he's in range of this tier 1 tower. Losing beam, power shot, right click, damage is just not enough. 110 life points, and then Naga. Then Naga, crit still here, looking for the Shackle. The line is almost perfect. The Shackle doesn't work in the end of the day because she kills him off too fast. Double damage and double TP out. Sven as well as Darkseer on the sidelines. Man, I love the positioning in this game. And it's just one to the next. And this Naga Windrunner combination setup. Saving the life of Luna. And Shadow Demon and Jakira are kind of taking it for the team. For a smoke game, that was meant to work a lot better for We as Asian. But it did not work. And then Arcane Boot. Get everything back. The mech comes off cooldown too. Trying to bring down this tier 2 tower. Fate Bolt will actually pull the creep wave down. But there should be enough damage if they're happy to tank it up. But they're not. They still fear what can happen if Nightstalker runs in. But it is daytime and he popped his ultimate during that last engagement so he was capable of fighting. And that wasn't enough for the end of the day. But then again, who needs to tank up when they can just like farm up the jungle and then push again? Naga's having a great old time with Not a Hax on the top lane. Has he got Riptide up again? Yeah, he does. That's not enough damage to kill off Not a Hax. Even with these illusions chasing around the tower. And then he war cries back to safety. Everything he's got. And then damage, bottom lane, crit already caught out. So nice Stalker on the sidelines, and Darkseer continued to actually TP in then. Didn't want to waste the time. Iron Shell will happen, but that creep won't survive long. The damage is already more than enough. If you got Lucent Beam, if you got Power Shot, there goes the Power Shot. The Iron Shell is gone. Nice path. If it caught our cry, then wants to be seeing his death. But didn't, and Not a Hax coming towards the bottom lane. To defend for the team, but at the same time, Naga takes out the tier 2 tower on the top lane. He'll push towards the tier 3. It's a 4-1. This is like classic MYM. This is Melk strat. Add pressure towards one lane, farm up the jungle, take out the other lane. And keep the team moving between the top and the bottom lane. Doesn't matter if you're raiding or dire, it works either way. If you're trying to push out the mid lane, then push out the bottom lane, that's a little bit easier for your defenders to get that support moving in between the lanes. But if you have to choose between north and south, that hurts a lot more. Now Shackle, oh man. The ward was there. They knew what was going on. And they actually knew there was a Radiant Ward there looking for it too, but the double damaging Luna comes in. Gets rid of the ward. Middle lane being pushed out. Naga, the split pusher. And teamfight controller now with a Diffusal Blade as well. Arctic looking amazing. I don't want to actually... If you're a German fan, you're just like, ahoy, vey. That wasn't German. That was actually... Yeah, no. So... Happy Hanukkah. Bottom lane pushing in. Bottom tower is under attack. And this is tier 2 tower gone. We as Asian will finally let this one fall. At the same time though, they gotta be cautious. Tier 2 tower is going to take a fall. And then it'll be a very quick Roshan and then maybe even a push into the base. Especially with the Mana Star recipe now finished up on Naga Siren. She leaves a couple of herself on that bottom lane. Should Riptide it up before they lose it, but nope. Time's out, now into Roshan. Mana style for both Luna as well as Naga. And that, yeah, smoke movement. This is their basically one and only chance. What level is Ribbit? He's not even level 6 yet! He's trying to pick it up in this middle lane, actually, from it. Yes, he gets level 6. Maybe he can steal something good. And in we move. Knight. Oh, Naga. No fun. No fun. Macro Pyre. Ice Punt. Catches three. Back or not. We've already got the Death of Bane. Sven to follow up. The Darkseer Wall is there, but it's not copying who they need. Crit's going to take a fall. The Diffusal Blaze dodges him. It's a triple kill. Triple kill going the way of the Luna. Ultra. Nope. Double kill. Coming the way of the Jakiro. Perfect setup. Get rid of the Darkseer Wall. Back into Roshan. Liazation threw everything they had into that. And they realized it was not going to help them at the end of the day. It was not going to help them. And Jakiro moves up towards the top lane now. 2.2k gold up for him. All the cash in the world flying in for Arctic. And you know that team fight's going to push it down further. 20,000 worth of the gold. Pushing the experience down as well. Courier's flying out. Vlad's? Nope. Starting up a sheep stick. Either that or Nova also wants to go Manta style. And then a haste rune to boot for the Naga Siren. Full Manta now completed, not just the Yasha and Diffusal. Full Manta. And then that's that kind of push. You can just sit yourself out just around this region here. And then just basically copy, 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 copy. And then send them this direction. Take out the tower. Very, very simple. Like the amount of copies right there? Because if you start doing the math for it, we're looking at Disruption Illusion. So there's two from that one. Then you got Luna with the Manta style. That's another two. And then you've got Naga, who'll make two from the Manta. So we're up to six. And then you can bind it up with the Mirror Images. So then you got three from that. You've actually got nine images. I was short by two. So you got nine images that can just keep on pushing the base every 30 seconds. Or 50 seconds, sorry. Very, very easy to do. Very, very easy to do. And that's just tower after tower. But if they take a team fight, then it's all over. Shackle doesn't latch and Snare is there and Cryer's locked in. He'll vac in once, but Jakiro gets the right click, even though a lot of that damage was done by Windrunner. But Darkseer's on the sidelines, so no ulti for him, no control from him. And also no buyback from him. Which means it's a 4v5 engagement. Disruption? Nope, we've got one level in Shadow Poison. Not what they needed. An Ice Path. Oh, this is another big catch out. Not a hack. Way too far out. The Shackle Line was there, but Nova decides not to take it. And now he's got a Shackle Line, but Nightmare happening. Disruption not helping him out. And Nova will come out of his Nightmare. And they haven't pushed in. They were hunting the kill instead. If they picked up Sven just then this would be a Rax. But not the case. Jakiro lining up for an Ice Path. Or a ward just deep inside the base. They know what's going on. And look at all these illusions. This is what we're talking about. Just so many Nagas. The stun will fly out. And this is Sven holding the ground. Nightmare, Bane Elemental. Wanting to go on Sven with a pullback into the back. That's the wall. That's really nicely done here from Arctic. But then again, Ice Path and just bouncing damage just keeps on flying through. They want this tier 3 tower. Power Shot flies as well. Would you believe Sven the only one to die during this? Power Shot being returned. Tower destroyed in the mid. Shackle won't latch. But all they want is this mid. And Nova sits on the edge now with Focus Fire. Trying to force Crit to come out and engage on him. There's the Iron Shell on the run. It is during nighttime. But Ice Path, no Crit! Don't be out that far! The Shackle won't latch, but he won't live! The damage is too much. The Purge is out in the Darkseer. And now it is the Eclipse of the Heart. The total Eclipse of the Heart. GG is the call. Coming out from Quashka. This is over. This is all she wrote. And Arctic Gaming. Very strong performance coming out. No, vamos. Vamos, Mirid. Well played. Well played, I say, sir. And thank you very much. That's actually going to wrap up our evening for the defense. Thanks for watching. Thanks for tuning in if you're tuning in on Dota TV. It's been great having you here. We'll be back tomorrow night. I believe we have only one game for the defense tomorrow night, and that's Empire going up against Pain. So the Russians will be going up against the Brazilians. That'll be the next game coming up tomorrow night. Comes up at 18 CET, so 6 p.m. that match. Maybe a little bit more of an earlier night. As far as the other matches go, we will be able to do a little bit more Star Series tomorrow. But maybe they're actually out of games now for Starladder. Well, I'll check the schedule. I'll check the schedule. But I can at least tell you the defense will be tomorrow night, 6 p.m., 18 CET on your Friday night of Dota. We'll be here for that one. And as far as all the other matches, just and everything Dota, keep your eyes on joindota.com. We'll let you know more about everything that is out there. Thanks for watching, guys. I'll see you tomorrow night.
I said good day, sir!